I guess this is it.
Do you remember the very last shot of Friends?
This is harder than I thought it would be.
It was so hard to say goodbye because, for one thing, we'd never have another chance to hang out with the gang in the prettiest, quirkiest, most comforting kitchen in the history of television.
Look at it, isn't it beautiful?
In popular culture, the kitchen is known as the heart of the home. So when Friends ended, you could say its heart stopped beating. By leaving their keys on the kitchen counter, the cast paid their respects to the place where they learned the rituals of adulthood and encouraged us to move on as well. This scene has become immensely nostalgic and goes a long way to show that the kitchen is the emotional core of any TV family. No matter how far a show's subject matter takes us from our own lives, a scene in a fictional kitchen grounds us in the familiarity of the everyday. Pouring tea, using the toaster, eating with family, rushing out the door, a sex scene, a midnight snack. As a transitional space between sleep, work, and play, the kitchen gets more screen time than you might realise, and the small moments that play out within it lay the foundations of the storytelling pact that help us believe the big moments in a character's life outside their home.
Are you okay?
If the kitchen is the window into the soul of its occupants, it's about time we go and take a peek.
You know what? Why don't you turn that music back on? It's kind of nice.
Look at any feel-good show, and a kitchen will be one of its central sets. According to scholar Robert Thompson, the television kitchen is mission control, the place from which the stories are launched out to the rest of the world. In family comedies, opening sequences typically unfold in the most lived-in room of the house. To recreate the familiar sense of harmony of the Tanner's kitchen, production designer Jerry Dunn looked at the original set before adding a few modern touches. "I want nobody to really notice it," he said. In the first scene of Modern Family, the intent is the opposite. The fridge's door keeps getting in the way of Claire's breakfast routine to indicate a more chaotic, hurried lifestyle.
Come on!
A general rule of TV kitchen design is normalcy. A room so banal that the extraordinary things that happen there are simply part of our everyday lives. Even death. The dark humour and satirical atmosphere of 6 Feet Under is conveyed from the kitchen in the pilot, where Ruth finds out that her husband has died, leaving the family in mortuary business without a patriarch. Her anger, pain, and grief are amplified and in total dissonance with the decor. With the roast she has meticulously prepared now on the floor, the unsettling tone of the show has been brilliantly established. Kitchen scenes are more meaningful than we think.
Your father is dead and my hot roast is ruined.
To better understand how the kitchen became such a powerful storytelling symbol, we have to go back to the 1950s and the advent of television in the US. In the aftermath of World War II, the home became the embodiment of the American dream. A well-equipped kitchen was the epitome of success, safety, and family values for the middle class. The term even entered Cold War politics during the kitchen debate, where President Nixon argued that America's sprawling suburbia was proof of national superiority. Suddenly, the humble kitchen was politicized. Kitchens have always been hybrid spaces that combine our private and public lives. They stage our private conversations over breakfast in pyjamas and our public theatre when we host friends for dinner. With women still expected to bear the brunt of domestic work, the kitchen is a place to explore their characters and buck expectations. In Big Little Lies, Madeline is a modern mother who, on the surface, has it all. But really, she is breaking under the weight of emotional labour and social pressure. Nevertheless, she thinks that she can save face by putting dinner out every single night. Little Fires Everywhere features the same actress, the same obsession with domesticity, and the same holier-than-thou attitude, but this time, Elena's disillusions go up in flames, literally. In the most extreme cases, the kitchen turns into a domestic prison where silent rebellion simmers until it explodes. As women continue to fight to redefine their role at home and in society, television has given us some incredible examples of female empowerment happening right in the kitchen. In Sex Education, Gina is a single working mum who takes a lot of pride in her beautiful home. Everything is arranged the way she likes it.
I didn't ask for a fucking pan shell.
Rearranging the kitchen is an unacceptable attack on her identity and sense of autonomy.
Your things are everywhere!
Also, let's not forget the TV trope of kitchen lovemaking.
In Girls, Marnie's Chinatown kitchenette may be the smallest you've ever seen, but is also the location of a memorable sex scene in which she puts her pleasure first. Empowered women know how to make the kitchen work for them.
Fresh cookies, hot from the oven.
Ooh. But what about men in the kitchen?
You put the giblets in a pan?
Yes, chef.
Thanks, a boy named Sue, chef.
The recent golden age of television has ushered in the dominance of anti-heroes on the small screen. Although they are family men, we rarely see them in the kitchen. When that happens, though, it can tell us more about their state of mind than any trip to the shrink.
Why does everybody need to talk about everything?
On paper, Mad Men's Don Draper has the picture-perfect life of 1950s America. As a busy ad man and womanizer, Don often neglects his domestic duties. Soon, the cracks start to appear in his marriage. After the failure of his and Betty's American dream, they both move on. But not before saying goodbye in the now empty, demilitarized space where their nuclear family imploded. Meanwhile, in Breaking Bad, Walter and Skyler's kitchen is dark and gloomy, as if danger and resentment are constantly lurking under the surface. Marital harmony officially ends with the now iconic line,
"I am the one who knocks."
But an earlier indicator of doom may be the passive-aggressive scene in which Walter, deprived of access to the bathroom, relieves himself in the kitchen sink and desecrates the home he's fighting to preserve. In House of Cards, Frank Underwood breaks his kitchen sink for no other reason than a tap dripping, which is a dark omen for his more violent outbursts later on. For better or for worse, we should never underestimate the symbolic power of the TV kitchen. The kitchen is one of the most powerful locations in filming. It brings to the boil character development, social context, and storytelling. And now that you know that every single detail is a deliberate reflection of the character's inner mental states, you will never look at that kitchen island in the same way again.
Tea, mug, kettle, you're welcome.
I didn't thank you.
You don't have to.
I won't.